Hello guys, welcome to detailed Python training course by software testing help. In our previous tutorials, we learned how to divide a huge code into smaller methods using functions and how to call or access them. We also discussed about some of the input and output operations that Python provides us and how to use them. And we also discussed about the operations on files. So today we discuss about one of the major and advanced concept of Python, that is OOPS concept, that is object-oriented programming concept. In that we will discuss about classes and objects and constructor. So what is a class and object? Okay, first of all, what is a class? Okay, so class in Python is a collection of objects. So we can think of a class as a blueprint or sketch or prototype. It contains all the details of an object. So when I say class, it means it's like a blueprint. So if I take a real world example, an animal is a class, okay? Because we have different kinds of animals in the world and all of these are belongs to a class called animal. So if you notice, the class animal will not exist in real world. We just call them as animals. It's a group, okay? And dogs, anything like lions, all those things are exist in real world, but animal will not exist. The word animal will not exist in the real world. We just call them as animals. Okay, it's like a blueprint. Okay, so now we'll see how to define a class in Python. So for that, we go to my notepad. So we'll say the syntax of class will look like this. So if you want to define a class, Python provides a keyword class called class. Then you have to provide a class name. Okay, similar to functions, but we'll use class here. Then block of code. Can write any number of codes here inside the class. You can write functions as well. You can write one more class inside this class as well. Okay, so let's see an example of it. Let me create one package, class objects. Here I will create one Python file, I'll name as class. Okay. So let's have a class, say class. I have to write a class name. I'll write my class name as my class. My class. Okay, start of the class. Then you can write any number. I will define some variable, that's it. A equal to 10. Say B equal to 20. Okay. Okay, that's it. I'll define these things. So if you see in the above example, we have declared a class called my class, and we have declared and defined some variables inside this class. Okay, so how to access these variables which are present inside this my class, that is A and B, outside of the class? So to access those things, you need to use a class thing. Like similar to function. So I have defined, suppose I have defined a function inside my function, I written some code. How will I access that function? We will call that function using a function name. Similarly, if you want to access the variables or functions which are present inside the class, we have two ways. One is using class name, or another by using object. So object we'll see later. Now we'll see how to access the A and B outside of the class using the class name. So we want to access it, just say come outside of the class. So now I will say print my class dot A or B. Okay, if I print it, it will should print me 20. Right. So this is how you access the code present inside the class my class using this thing. This is the class name. Okay. So similar thing, we can access the same thing using objects. So first we will see what is object. An object is usually an instance of a class. It is used to access everything present inside the class. Okay. If I say everything present means every code present inside of the class can be accessed using objects. Okay. So now we will see how to create an object. So to create an object, first we will define a variable. Okay, variable name. Variable name can be anything equal to class name. So for which class you want to create an object, that class name you have to provide here. The variable name can be anything. Okay. Suppose example, this is my variable name, and I want to access the code present inside my class. So I will say equal to my class. That's it. So this is the syntax. So let's see this the example. Okay. So I will define some functions as well inside the class. Some addition function, add function I will define. Say. So if you see here inside the class, I have defined a function called add. Okay. As soon as I define the function, the self variable will get created. Okay, a self is like an object. Okay, so when you're creating a function inside the class, make sure that self is there. Okay, you can remove it, but it should be there. Actually, if it is not there, also the function code will work. But if you use self, it is better. Okay, so now I will say sum. So why are you using a self? I will tell you. Okay, so now I want to add a plus b will add. Okay, if you see, if I'm also over, you will see unresolved reference a, which means it cannot access a. So you have defined that a variable and b variable, but it is not able to access it. So how will access? Using the self. So self will reference to this object, so this class called my class. This self will reference to this my class. So using this reference, I will access A. So it's a self dot, if you see A, right? So same thing, self dot B. So this is the reason you should use self inside the function. So now I will say print sum. Okay. So now we will create an object. Now this is using the class name, create an object. Say ob, it's my variable name. I want to create object for my class. Okay, now we print using the object. So now ob will become object. So ob dot a, or print ob dot b, and I will call this function add. Okay, ob dot add. Okay, so now we'll execute this. We'll see 10, 20, and 30. 10 is the value of a, 20 is the value of b, 30 is the sum of a and b. So if you see here, ob dot a nothing but 10, ob dot b is nothing but 20, ob dot add, that means I'm calling the function which is present inside my class. So it will do this operation and will print the sum. So this is how to access the variables or functions or code present inside of the class using the object. Okay. So Python is like everything in Python is an object. Whenever you write a code, you will have to use classes and object. The class and object are the pillars of Python, you can say, or pillars of object-oriented programming language. So now we will see constructor. Okay, what is constructor? So constructor in Python is a special method which is used to initialize the members of a class during runtime when the object is created. So, which means in Python, we have some special built-in class methods which starts with the double underscore. Okay, they have special meaning in Python. So in Python, if we want to define a constructor, we have to define it by underscore underscore init, double underscore init, double underscore parenthesis. So this is the constructor. So in Java, we'll write the same class name. Like if you want to create a object, so a constructor for my class, you will say my class. So that is in Java. Okay. But in Python, all constructor, every constructor will have this. If you want to create a constructor, you have to use this constructor. So every class must have a constructor. Even if you don't create a constructor explicitly, it will create a default constructor by itself. Okay, but that will be not visible to us. Okay. When you execute it, it will by in the backend, it will create its own default constructor. Unless you explicitly define it. If you explicitly define it, then it will not create. Okay. So let's see with some example. Create one Python file, say constructor. Okay. I'll say class, my class. Now we'll say sum equal to zero. Okay. Now we'll create a constructor, say define underscore init. You can see, right? The first one. So this is the constructor. Okay. So the constructor, I'm passing two the parameters, that is A and B. Okay. Then I'll say self dot sum equal to A plus B. I'm not at all using self dot A because A and B are local variables for this constructor. Okay. When it is a class variable, then you have to use self. Okay. So these A and B variables will have access to only this function. Okay. Now I will say one more function. I will print this up. Print some method, then here I'll print sum of A and B is self dot sum. Now I'll create an object. OB is equal to my class. So if you see here, it has to accept two parameters. When you create a constructor, so it will when you create an object, it will call the constructor automatically. No need to call the constructor explicitly. Okay, I'll say 20 comma 30. Okay, I'm creating this object, then the constructor will be called automatically. Then I will call this function print sum. Let me execute this. So sum of A and B is 50. So if we see here, this is my constructor. Okay. So this constructor is the what we can say. It's not a function actually. You can say like it's not a function, but it is a it's like a constructor is a class, almost like a class. But when you create an object for this class, this constructor will be automatically called. See, my class don't have any parameters. Okay, for class we don't create a parameters. Okay, so if you want to call the class using parameters, then we will define this constructor. Then I will call this. Okay, so if you see here, I'm not all calling ob.init. Because constructor will be called automatically when the object is created for it. Okay. After that, it will perform this operation. Then this is not a constructor, this is a normal method. Hence, I'm calling this explicitly. Okay. So this is about constructor. So today we learned about what are classes, objects, constructors, which are the main pillars of object-oriented programming language and Python. So these three are the main things which they will ask you in the interview as well. So in my next video, we'll discuss what are inheritance. What are the types of inheritance? Inheritance is also a concept of OOPs that we will discuss. Thank you, guys.